Diara yahoo kibaba gejo sisi yo yanga sisi yo ya baga aucho maxi okra sisi yo yanga sisi yo ya gwede aziz ki Musunda, sisi yo yanga, sisi yo yanga.
Hello, Mr. Vic.
Hello, bro.
You'll be getting the Tanzanian vibes. All right, beautiful game of football. Yeah, by the way, how are you doing today?
Yeah, I'm okay, I'm fine, I'm approximately normal.
You look stressed.
Yeah.
Okay.
Life is happening.
Of course, obviously. Beautiful game of football, Tanzanian league. Giving us the vibes. But I have my own reservations about today's game. We saw JKT Tanzania taking on young Africans. My brother, the pitch was an eyesore.
Oh, my God!
The pitch was an eyesore. I mean, in fact, I don't just know how I'm going to describe it. But that aside, let me just get your 2 cents about the matchup today.
Okay. Since you want us to start from the pitch, let's describe the pitch
please,
now.
Please do.
But then, where do I even start? Okay, let me start from the pitch. The pitch looks like a rice farm.
sorry to you guys. Truth must be told.
But we've seen the reason why this game was moved to today. You just wonder what happened yesterday. How the pitch looked like. That it was moved to today. Please, Africans, we are more than this. Come to think of it, this club is a sweet super club with so much history. JKT, for our viewers out there that are not used to African football, that are learning just as we are learning too, should know that JKT Tanzania is not a club to joke about. This club was established in 1971.
Wow.
And since then, they've been very, very active, playing good football. What is their game plan? They defend and they counter. That is how they've been playing football. And we saw that on the pitch today. They did not give... In fact, their formation was more like 11-0-0. Nobody in the midfield, nobody in the attack. All the 11 come to the back. And we saw what happened today. When they get the ball, the way they move like bees.
Swarm of bees.
My brother, the way they go and choke you immediately. Omo. That's to tell you how good this club too is. Mm. Because, I understand the pitch was so bad. So one would say that it was on a level playing ground, okay, we could have also seen, the excellence that comes with playing for young Africans. We also even saw it today. We saw it today because even with a bad pitch, hey, this Aziski. In fact, I'm thanking God that at the end of the day, they did not go back home with broken teeth and broken faces because of how bad this pitch was. But then they came out to play. And you saw a side that they just want to end this season as quickly as possible. Mind you, they are 59 points. After today's draw, they are 59 points, 5 points behind Azam. And 5 points might look so big, but it's not that big, because they still have about 7 games to go.
That's huge.
7 games to go. In fact, if every team is winning, especially Azam is winning and winning, I mean, it will take young Africans 15 points to clinch the title. So, as you can see, anything can still happen. This is football. If they just attempt to have two losses from the 7 games and you find Azam winning all their matches, the league will be over for the young Africans. And that's the reason why they also came out today to play. I was wondering why would some top players of young Tanzania will be exposed to this kind of pitch. And mind you, football is money. Why am I saying this? Because summer is coming. Many of these guys might leave young Africans and young Africans and go to Europe and go and make some money for the club too, because the club needs money to run. Part of the club is when you are still winning your medal, there are some people that need to go so that you cash out and keep running your club. Reason why you cannot see young Africans in a pitch like this, because they have some financial backing. And you've seen JKT, it was a rich club, or just let's say averagely rich club, I'm not sure that we'll be seeing this kind of pitch, because it also needs money to manage it. Manage the pitch.
Definitely.
But then one big will I say sight that I saw today was seeing that the JKT fans turned up for their people. Even with that harsh, it was not a comfortable scene because there were no seats.
You saw people stand, the majority of people. Some were
hanging. Is it a swing-like structure? Or is it a rooftop? I don't understand.
It's just a love
but
for
then,
football.
Come on, brother. It's a love for football. We saw them out there. And even singing for, oh God, football, football. Mm. That is why the economy of football can never run dry. And that's why we are preaching for African nations. Nigeria, we cannot talk much about this. Just imagine, with the numbers that we saw today in a club like JKT, with that bad pitch, if we can be getting those numbers in our beloved Nigerian league,
we'll be happy.
That's okay. That's okay.
That's true.
So, but then, I need to say this, and this goes out to young Africans out there. You guys have excellent players out there, okay? But today, I think the condition was just too harsh for you to expose those guys. But then, like we said, the league still belongs to nobody.
For now.
Mm. Even the Simba that is third position, anything can still happen. I know, yes. Mathematically, yes. Let me hear. Mathematically, anything can still happen. Even Simba can have the league, okay? Did I enjoy myself at the end of the day? Yes, because I saw fine play. Even in the bad pitch, as the ski was there, the players from JKT came at the turn up. They even hit the bar. They had more possession at a time. The first half of the game, they had 51 against 49. Mm. And you saw these guys come out to play. But then, why are they even playing this way? One will also ask. Because they are sitting below. 23 points, 17 position. And you know, in Tanzanian League, we're talking about 16 teams. And they are third below. Okay. And what that means that, mind you, in Tanzania team, four teams out of four, lowest teams, the second lowest are automatically relegated. No option of fine. No option of qualification. And JKT have found themselves currently as a situation where they can play qualifiers,
relegation qualifiers.
Okay, So but then let's see how it goes. I think it's a fine team. I think it's a team that, but the prayers will not be for them not to play at home because that pitch is not good. Is that the prayers they will be praying? Why others are praying that they will stay at home and play because they have a fine pitch? These guys will be praying to go away.
You can imagine that.
Almost. But at the end of the day, Swiss football from Tanzania football, we are enjoying what you guys are doing out there, and we cannot relent to keep pushing.
All right, thank you so much. All right, dear viewers, I believe you've been enjoying this wonderful conversation going on right here. This is Football Intel. And if you want to know more about this wonderful channel, why don't you just go into the description box. Every detail about Football Intel and what we do is contained in that description box. And if you're watching this for the very first time, please do me a favor. Just below your screen, you have the subscribe button. Click on that subscribe button. Don't stop there. Go ahead and activate the notification bell and be up to date with our latest video. And to those of you, our returning subscribers, who I fondly refer to as our family members, we can never stop saying thank you for the likes and shares on our channel. We are so grateful. Thank you for the comments, especially in the last video we did, the Tanzanian. I think the last match Young Africans had.
Simba.
We saw the wonderful and amazing comments you guys were giving us back to back. And we started it, and we're going to continue with that.
We die here, that's
a Nigerian slogan. We die here. All right, so remember that we at Football Intel, we have a vision, and that's placing African football on the world map. And guess what, guys, we ain't going to relent until that becomes a reality. So keep liking, keep sharing, keep commenting. Remember that those comments of yours help us to know how you guys feel about the content we create and the ways which we can improve to keep giving you guys top notch content. At this point and at this juncture, I'll be drawing the curtain. Thanks for joining me. I still remain your host of this wonderful platform, Football Intel, Mr. Dominion Chukwu. And of course, alongside me, top-notch soccer analyst, Mr. Victor Siokwu. Permission to fall out of the studio till we come your way again next time. Bye-bye.